Hi, in this part you are going to learn using opening tool and combine with stair tool. At the beginning, let's draw a slab here and insert our walls onto it with magic wand tool. Select all and copy it other stories. I suggest you to suspend group selection for working easier. Let's go to opening tool right here and click anywhere on the slab. As you can see, a symbol appeared, but it only created one hole, which we clicked. If you want to use this tool more than one element, we need to add other slabs or elements. But before that, let's enlarge this opening. It's very similar with slab tool. We need to click edges and drag. After doing this, let's go to 3D view and click the opening edges to select. You will see extrusion button. Click it and drag downside. It didn't make hole on the other slabs. We need to use click this add tool with plus symbol. After that, click other slabs. As you can see here, all slabs were opened. Now we can select this opening tool and increase its sizes. Let's inspect its settings now. Press Ctrl plus T. By this tool, you can change its floor plan symbol, size or visibility. There are only two choices for now. Rectangle or circle opening tool. Let's inspect the circle one. You can also use opening tool onto walls. The way is the same with slab. Just alt-click the opening and click anywhere on the wall. Click the plus and add other slabs and to cut the other walls out. I click the slab, but Archicad doesn't see the slab. It sees the wall that we cut, so we need to go behind the wall. In my opinion, this opening tool needs to develop. It's still at the beginning. We can't use this on the shells, meshes and morphs. Maybe they intend this for only installation. But there is a designing part for this job, and they need to think multiple ways. For example, if you have watched my wavy facade design, I couldn't use this. I have used other native techniques. I wish there are options like polyline selection or curve transform. Anyway, let's go to the stair tool. I like the stair tool. It's very useful and easy to use. More complex design won't be problem if you use. Let's go to floor plan. Press F2. You can make active the stair tool right here. And click anywhere on the screen. But before doing this, I want to show the settings. For example, this is the orientation. Like the wall, it's got three options: outside, center, and inside. After selecting your orientation, the offset value can be changed from here, as well as bottom and top offset. This is the stair width, but it can be changed too after placing the stair, and you are completely free when designing. Let's make this 1200 mm and leave this 100. Starting shapes can be changed here. We can make start from riser or treat or finish. You can decide where the stair will be begin from here and where to end. Let's start drawing the shape of the stair. It's very easy. Just click the start point and move your mouse. But before this, I suggest you to draw any sketches before. Click again to finalize the stair. Let's make another shape stair. I'm just click here and move the mouse. Then click again. After that, I select the second part of the stair. Let's rotate it 90 degrees and click again to finish second part. After that, select standard stair shape again and finalize the stair. Let's make another stair. This time I want to change landing with rises. I'm just gonna start from here and click here. Direction isn't correct, so I change from here. After that, I move on drawing and click the start second part. Then select the landing shape with binder. I move the mouse and click again. This time I finalize the stair with formal stair. If I could change the winder with standard risers, these corners would be winder type. In this case, I have to click these parts and translate them with winders. I click the corners. In the opening box, I click this button. I'm going to the same steps here. This is the main shape of the stair. It didn't finish. You can change its size, shape, design with these blue lines and green lines. To change the main shape and size, you can click these blue lines and can drag inside or outside. If you accidentally click a wrong place, Archicad offers you another shapes. You can just select one of them and continue with your stair. If you click this button, you can add risers here in exchange for other risers. For example, I want to finish both arms at the same line. In order to achieve that, I click the finishing points and moving them. Once I did that, I will see a green reference line to align and I click again. As you can see, I reduce one step here and other step was automatically created. This was the main shape of the stair. To change the detail or further editing, you can click the green lines. For example, you can change this straight line to curved one. Or you can add points and make polygonal. I think it's fun to do this. Very interesting designs can be created. You are completely free. After making this nonsense and never built stair, I'm just gonna go to 3D view. I move inside the building with explore mode. You can click the little man symbol at the 3D visualization menu. Here is the arch stair. You can see the curves we created. Let's make an opening for our stairs. I'm just going to floor plan and click the opening tool. And click the slab. Opening tool covered our stair. We need to change its visibility in the settings. Click the opening and press Ctrl plus T. Scroll down and you will see cover face option. Just uncheck this and click OK. Click the edges and intersect with the shape of the stair. We need to turn off this black symbol. You just go to settings again and go to this panel. Move this arrow to left. It's invisible now. In the 3D window, we can see that only one slab cut. Therefore, we are going to add other slabs to selection. Just click the opening and click the box with plus symbol and click other slabs. Let's go to mathematical options for the stair. Click the stair and press the Ctrl plus T for the settings. These are the values for the riser number, height, going distance and stair width. This is the height for the riser. And these are the rules for our stairs. We can determine the max and minimum distances. As you can see, they determine a gap value. If you need a fixed distance, you just input both same number. At this moment, this stair is linked to story 1. If story 1 height is changed, stair height will be changed. I select this unlinked and input 4 meters for the height. Now this stair is unlinked and its height won't be changed depending on the story height. You can change the height of the story in 3D window too. You need to go to 3D view and select the stair. You can just click this blue point and click this button in the opening window for the extrusion. As you can see here, riser heights are changing when I change the main height. To prevent this, I'm just going to settings and fix the numbers as the same. Now all the risers set to the same height. Let's measure this at floor plan. Press M button and measure the riser. As you can see, it's 300 mm. Okay, that's all it for this beginner tutorial for the stairs. Thank you for watching.